Hello everyone, welcome once again to our session. Today we are going to solve one example for our topic, trigonometric substitution. So we're given here the integral of the square root of 1 plus x squared dx. If this is given in your exam, and then we try the different procedures. We can say that those procedures that we had discussed cannot be applied, right? But what if you look at this part, class, this part here, this square root of 1 plus x squared. This is just the same as square root of 1 squared plus x squared. So if you look at this, we can say that this involves Pythagorean theorem, right? So from our Pythagorean theorem, if we have this right triangle, and say this is our x, and say this is our 1, so our hypotenuse is square root of the square of the two legs. So we have 1 squared plus x squared. So that's Pythagorean theorem. Now, if we are going to use tangent or what trigonometric functions that you want to use, so assuming this is our angle theta, now if we are going to take the tangent of that angle theta, so tangent of that angle theta, what is the definition of tangent? So definition of tangent is opposite over adjacent. So our opposite of this angle is this side, and adjacent is this side. So we have x over 1. Right? So we can say that tangent theta is just equal to x. All right? So therefore, we can substitute, instead of writing x here, we can substitute this one here. Therefore, we can write our integral as the integral of the square root of 1 plus, so instead of x, we use this tangent theta, which is equal to x. So we have tangent theta, which is for our x, but this is squared, so we can also square this. Okay, and then we have here our dx times dx. But take note, class, that this should match. If we have theta here, this differential here must be in terms of theta. This should be matched. Then how to get the equivalent expression of dx in terms of theta? So from our result of this tangent equal to x, if we are going to take the derivative, if we take the derivative of this with respect to x, so we have the derivative of tangent theta with respect to x is equal to, what is the derivative of tangent? The derivative of tangent is secant squared theta. Right? So take note that our tangent theta is equal to x. You take the derivative, that is secant squared theta. And so this should be with respect to theta. Okay, so with respect to theta. So derivative tangent theta with respect to theta is equal to secant squared theta. So therefore, our differential of tangent of theta is equal to secant squared theta. But take note that our tangent theta is equal to x. So we have dx equal to, sorry, this is multiplied by d theta. So secant squared theta d theta. So we can replace dx with this equivalent, this secant squared theta d theta. So now our expression, our integral now is square root of 1 plus tangent squared theta multiplied by dx, where our dx is equal to secant squared d theta. Okay, so this is theta, then multiplied by secant squared theta d theta, because our dx is equal to this one. So we substitute also the value of equivalent of dx, which is secant squared theta, with this one. Okay? Then from our trigonometric identities, if you can still remember, no, from our previous discussions. So from our trigonometric identities, we have one plus tangent squared theta, this is equal to secant, this is equal to secant squared theta. So we can make use of this identity class. So therefore, we can replace this expression 1 plus tangent squared theta with secant squared theta. So therefore, our integral now becomes integral of secant squared theta square root, then times secant squared theta d theta. Okay? And we have here square root, and then we have the exponent, so we can eliminate this radical and exponent, which is 2. The index is 2, the exponent is 2, so that cancels out. So therefore, our expression now, okay, I will make use of the other cardboard. So our expression now becomes the integral of secant theta multiplied by secant squared theta d theta, which is equivalent to the integral of secant cube theta d theta. Still remember this one? In our previous topic class, we have in our topic integration by parts, so we already have solved this. Okay, I will not go to that again, to that process again. We know already what is the answer for this part, so I'll go directly to the equivalent expression of this. So what is the integral of this one? I'll go directly to that one. I will not go to that process again. So you just check now, we have the video on that part, or for this part. So I'll go to the answer immediately. So we have the integral of secant cube theta d theta. This is equivalent to 1/2. If you forget this one, just review our previous video. So we have solved this already. This is equivalent to 1/2 secant theta times tangent theta, then plus 1/2 ln of the absolute value of secant theta plus tangent theta. Then we have plus C, right? So still remember this? Yeah, plus C. Okay? But don't be happy, huh? If you reach at this point, you're not done yet. Alright, so we're not done yet. We still have to substitute back what we have done in the beginning. We use x equal to tangent theta, so we have to return that into this answer. So again, we have to make use of the triangle. So if you can still remember, no, from our triangle, right triangle, so we have labeled this part as our x, right? And this is our 1, and this is our square root of 1 plus x squared. Okay? And this is our theta, our angle here. So, from this triangle, we can get our secant theta. Secant theta from our definition, that is, what is our secant theta? Our secant theta is hypotenuse over adjacent. Okay, so hypotenuse, which is square root of square root of 1 plus x squared divided by 1, or simply equal to square root of 1 plus x squared. So that's our secant theta. How about our tangent theta? Our tangent theta is equal to, so from this triangle, tangent is opposite over adjacent. So this is just x over 1, or simply equal to x. Then substitute this back to this result. So we will get 1/2. So instead of secant theta, so we have square root of 1 plus x squared and times tangent theta, where our tangent theta is equal to x. Okay, so tangent theta is equal to x, so times x. Okay, so this is for this part, secant theta, 1/2 secant theta tangent theta. Okay, so this is our secant theta, this is our tangent theta, then plus 1/2 ln of secant theta. Once again, our secant theta is square root of 1 plus x squared, then plus tangent theta, which is equal to x. Then we have plus c. So this is our final answer. Okay? So I hope you're able to follow the process, class. Thank you. And see you again in our next video. Bye.